All right, everyone, welcome back to another episode of Enigmatica 6. I hope everyone's doing great. I know that I am. We're jumping on into our game save. I have done a little bit of work off camera since the last episode, and I know that the last episode was actually kind of long. It was kind of funny. I was editing it. Well, I was re-watching it because I don't actually edit my videos, but I was re-watching it, and I realized that I said I wasn't going to go as in-depth on the bees as like a full tutorial, and then I ultimately did that anyway. So, I mean, it is what it is. I enjoy the mods. Sometimes I just kind of go a little bit overboard with explaining things, which, hey, it is what it is, but I hope you guys still enjoyed that previous episode. If you didn't get a chance to catch it, highly recommend going back and re-watching it, or watching it, I should say. If you haven't seen it, you're not going to re-watch it. But anywho, so there's a ton of stuff that we still need to do today as well. We're not going to focus too much on the bees because we spent the whole episode last time going through it. But I have a few other things that I would really like to start tinkering in. And then we're going to go from there. So first, let me recap you on some of the stuff we've done. So as you can see, we have our little beehives here. And I was considering like going back and completely redoing them, maybe making them bigger, maybe even making like a huge, like atrium, apiary, like, I forget what they call, they're exactly called, but, you'll see them a lot, like butterflies and things like that at like nature preserves or zoos and things like that. Or if you've seen Jurassic Park, they have that huge one where they keep the pterodactyls in them. Something like that would be really cool, just so they could all float around and they don't have to necessarily be contained to a small space. But then I was also thinking that, well, for one, that would look kind of ugly. Let's be completely honest. It's kind of nice to have them separated out. And then two, we're going to get to an apiary anyway, which is going to be a big structure anywho. So I didn't really feel like having a big structure within a big structure, and then it's just a bunch of structures. So we're going to keep it this way. I think an apiary would fit very, very nice right on into here next to it. So we do have our bees going. The one thing I didn't go over in the last episode was actually how to get the honeycomb out of here. At least I don't believe I did. So we have our bee smoker and scraper here. So what you can do is you can come on in here. As you see right here, there is this yellow honey that is kind of dripping out the side. All you got to do so that the bees don't get mad at you is you do a little smoke on it. As you can see, it shows you how much time you have. And then you just right click with your scraper. And there you go. You're going to get all of your honeycomb. And then the same can be done over here as well. So we could give them a little smoke and then grab all those. Now, there are ways to automate this. We have automated in the past in previous episode or previous series, I should say. But for the time being, excuse me, I got my coffee here. I got to take a sip. For the time being, we're going to leave it as is, a little bit manual. And then once we get a little bit, once we get some more bees that I actually want, then we'll kind of go from there. So we're going to definitely have to do some exploration. So we'll probably have a couple episodes where we go out and we do some more exploration, maybe try to find some more of those structures and so on and so forth. We do have the mechanical centrifuge up and going. I built this because I had made the original, I made this centrifuge and I realized it needed power. So I ultimately got the mechanical one. If you do follow along in your quests here for the bees, it'll walk you through it right down here. Just make sure you're checking things off. Otherwise, the line of quests will not progress. So all you got to do is you throw your honeycomb in here. You get your glass bottles in here. And then you got to shift and you right click. Makes this extremely gross noise. But every time it clicks there, that means it's going through the process. As you can see, we went through a couple of our honeycomb. We got some sugar. We got some beeswax. And we got some honey bottles, or at least one honey bottle, and we could actually drink this. I guess we've never had honey, and there we go. We actually gained an additional heart, which is awesome. Wasn't actually expecting to do that. I kind of thought that we had already, we already had the honey, but I guess not. So, anywho, so that's gonna be it. Again, guys, I didn't want to really even spend that much time on the bees, but I figured I would give you a well-rounded response to everything to get you up and going on that. And again, following the quest lines are gonna be your best bet. The other thing I did go ahead and do off-camera was, obviously this. So I did a lot of work over here. We got some more paths going. We have a path all the way up to the the cliffside valley lodge or whatever we want to call it. I ended up making a path here. Now this is not the most ideal. It's not what I ultimately want end goal, But it gets us going for the time being. It just makes it look a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. Eventually, the goal is to probably get into create and have some like elevators and such that will make it a lot easier, or moving platforms, whatever it may be. We got a lot of different options for it. But yeah, I think it's looking really nice. We're going to have to add some trees in and such down there to fill it out a bit more. And then I did actually go down to our farms there to grab some more food because I wanted to try some different things out, some different types of food out here in our cooking for blockheads. I'm not going over this too much because it's fairly self-explanatory. I, again, just recommend getting as much food as you possibly can and trying out what you can make. And then obviously keeping a good amount on you. Like for us, we have spaghetti, PB&J, fish stew, so on and so forth. So it's a very good way to go about it. We got our horse down here too, just chilling out. But anyway, okay, we finally can now get into what I actually want to do today. So, one of the big things that I'm running into is, honestly, a way to get sand. We do have ways that we can fairly easily. We go, it just involves some traveling. We have to go all the way to the ocean or to the river, and we just get a bulk of sand, and we bring it on back, and then we're good to go. But realistically, it's not the most ideal, and it's a lot of traveling. So, what I was thinking is we get into something that I actually have never gotten into before, and that is the Pedestals mod. So, this is actually underneath the Logistics tab. I know it's hard for you guys to see what tab exactly it's under, but you'll find it in your quest line. And the Pedestals mod is actually something really, really cool. I feel like in terms of realisticness, it's not like that realistic. You know, you have Mekanism or Thermal and things like that. Other mods are the Bees mod slightly. It's like, okay, I could fairly see this. This is diving more into like kind of magic type of scenario, even though it's not really magic, from my understanding of it. So it even tells you magically technological item displays. Oh my gosh. All right, so I'm going to read through this, and then we're going to actually get into getting what we need for it. So pedestals look pretty and do a great job of showing off collector's pieces, but they can do much, much more. Through a series of augments, upgrades, and enchantments, they can perform a number of useful tasks throughout your base and look good doing it. We'll be covering a selection of useful functionality that you can deploy throughout your base. But if you want to learn even more than these quests, JEI or in-game manuals can teach you the pedestals. The developer does have a wiki as well that you could utilize, blah, blah, blah. We're going to check the box. We're going to grab the pedestals and get the first one off the list here. Now, it did say an in-game manual, so I am a bit curious. Like, do we have a pedestals mod in or book in here? We do. Perfect. So there we go right here. So getting started. Work in progress. Wait, what does it say? Work in progress. Check videos for now. How to interact in an external link. Okay. Well, that's nice. So, I guess don't use the book because the book is not ready in game for it, which is fine. But we're going to go off the quests here to make it a little bit more straightforward. So the next thing that we're going to want to get is the pedestal linking. So using a linking tool. So pedestals could transfer displayed items from one to another by linking them together, which is kind of cool. So you could move items around, which is really awesome. And especially if you get some augments and enchantments, you could even get a whole process up and going. They can also transfer fluids, power, and experience as well. Wow, okay. So this kind of goes through how we're going to do this. But I'm going to try to read through this really quickly. Each sending pedestal can be linked a maximum of 8 receivers. Receivers can link to a number of senders. You can right-click a sender with linking the one, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so we need one of these. We're going to need red dye, green dye, and blue dye, which is perfectly fine. We should be able to get all that going, and then just a stick and diamond. And luckily, we pretty much have all of that good to go here. Now, I'm not really using this because it's still slow. I actually did end up putting some upgrades on here. I got to a couple medium speed upgrades and things on there. To help out, but it's still really, really slow, which I'm not the biggest fan of. All right, let me get these ingredients together for us. All right, guys, so for this recipe, we need to have red, blue, and green dye. Now, normally in Minecraft, green dye, the easiest way to get it is from cooking up cactus. Now, unfortunately for us, we don't really have that easily of a supply of cactus, but there are other ways that we can go about it, which is really nice. And if you pull it up, you can see here, the main thing is going to be our pestle and a mortar. So if we take this and we take a fern, we can get ourselves some green dye. Super useful tool to have. Highly recommend getting one of these up and going from Botania. It's not expensive. We've used it in the past. 100% recommend it. All right, so I'm just going to go into our normal crafting grid here. We need that. I'm trying to remember offhand the exact recipe, vice versa. There we go. And we have our linking tool. Perfect. All right, we can put that green dye away. And again, guys, make sure you're grabbing these progressions as you go. We're going to get some gold from that. Now, from there, there's a couple different paths that we can go. We have redstone control, we have augments, and then we have upgrades. So augments can be added to a pedestal to enhance a pedestal's item setting behavior. So pretty much, I'm guessing, it says it right down here. You can increase speed, capacity, range, particle diffuser, and maybe that's there might be another one as well. Oh, round robin augment as well. So there's a couple different ones that you can get in there. I'm guessing speed, capacity, and range are probably going to be your big ones that you want to go with. Particle diffuser is going to be good for reducing possible lag if you're sending a lot of stuff. So something cool to keep in mind there. So we might do some of that there. We do have to get some augments going, though. We have to create a speed, transfer, and range one in order to complete that. But let's get into the upgrades first and foremost. And it looks like from there it will divvy out into a couple different options here. So the pedestal upgrades, these are going to be the big boys that we want to deal with and what I'm ultimately working towards to actually get sand, which I don't think I fully explained, that through the pedestal mod, you can actually get it where you can get a crusher. So it would crush up the, I think it will take gravel and make it into sand, which would be extremely useful just because gravel is a little bit easier to find, or just stone in general, or I believe we might even be able to use it for ores. I'm not 100% sure on that. We're going to test it out today. So, functions to your displays. Displaying an item and moving them between pedestals is good, but you can add additional functionality with upgrades. You'll need a number of these upgrades, upgrade bases to get started. Pedestal upgrades can be added to your pedestals by holding them in your offhand and right-clicking the pedestal. You can be removed by holding another upgrade or upgrade tool in your offhand while left-clicking the pedestal. Okay, so we got to make some of these. Actually, not too bad. They pretty much gave us everything we already need for it. They gave us some gold ingots, which are going to give us 5 of those. Again, we'll hop back in. We completed that, so we're going to get some more. And we did get a rare pedestal loot box. So let's see what we ultimately get from that. And then from there, a couple different ways that we can go. So we have storage tanks, which is pretty cool. I am a little bit curious, though, because there are an item tank. Upgrade isn't running at peak efficiency. Unlock full potential. Apply advanced enchantment to it. Okay, max storage. Wow, that's a big storage upgrade. But I don't know if it works for everything or if it's a single item. It doesn't really tell us right there. I would like to know. Let's take a quick peek back in here. Capacity enhancement. Okay, interesting. Okay. Well, anyways, let's see here. So item transfer, fluid transfer, XP input, and then that's going to kind of branch off into a number of different things here. So it does look like we have to have energy and item transfer in order to head down this line, which has the crusher upgrade that I ultimately want. Now, you can go for a number of different things, which we're going to test out. Don't worry, guys. We are going to have a good time with this and try it out as much as we can. We could get a cobblestone generator. Ooh, that will be really good. I think that one first would be the most logical one, because we would want to get cobblestone to then eventually crush it down into what we would want, right? And it's kind of hard to find cobblestone here. So we would need an item import and an item export. So being able to move items from pedestal to pedestal is great, but being able to interact with the inventories is even better. Import and export augments allow you to do just that. Import will pull from an inventory below the pedestal and into its display slot, while export will push the items from the display slot into the inventory below. Okay, that makes sense. So we need to get these up and going. So we're going to need a hopper, right? Pedestal upgrade. There we go. And then if we go back, we're going to need an export one, which is just the same one. It's an import put back into it. So we're going to need two hoppers. All right, let's get this. All right, we got both of those made up. We're also going to get another rare pedestal loot box here. And it looks like we might have gotten multiple from that, but that did unlock for us a whole bunch of stuff, which is awesome. And I think it actually unlocked some of this stuff down here as well. Even though it was tied to this energy transfer one, it unlocked a lot of stuff. Okay, I guess if you didn't want to go this path and you went down here, it would unlock it as well. Or maybe you need to have this for certain things on here. I have no idea. But anyway, cobblestone generator. This is really what I want to do. I think this one would be really cool. So by default, this will generate cobblestone and place it in the display. It will add up to a stack of cobblestone to display and then continue to buffer more until it hits its capacity limit. All right, you can also modify, produce, generate. Okay, we're going to go for this. And I think we have everything we need. I have a bucket of water in my backpack here. So let's throw that in there. And we are going to need one more of those in there. And let's request what we need. There we go. And then we should be good to go. Now, I believe you can actually, yeah, you can make different ones as well, like different colored ones if we really, really wanted to. Right-click a pedestal with a colored palette will make it change. What is that? What is the colored palette? Is it just a color? Is it that's what it's saying? Like, you just take a dye and then you put it on there? There we go. We did get that. Let's again grab this. We're going to get Silk Touch enchantment, which is really nice. If you guys are looking for an easy way to get Silk Touch right off the bat, there you go, right there. So on these, we did get a pedestal area of one, and we did get pedestal speed one as well. All right, let's take a look here, because I would like to change the colors on these, and I don't know how easy it's going to be. You guys know, who have been watching along with the series, that I love me some purple. So we're going to go with purple on these, and we'll give it a go. So I think the best place to set this up will be over here, just for the time being. And we'll kind of just see how we ultimately have to, figure things out. So we wanted to go down into an inventory below it, correct? So we're gonna put two here, just like so. Okay, that's not what I wanted. Right clicking. Do I combine it in an inventory, or am I just not understanding this correctly? Colored with colored palettes. Okay, what does that mean? What does colored palettes mean? If I could spell. Colored palettes. Oh, okay. Isn't that a quest in here? Yeah, pedestal aesthetics. Cool. Okay, so you got to get paper to do this. All right, give me 1 second, guys. All right, guys, we got it up and going here. I was tinkering around with it just to test it out. So, again, pretty straightforward to get it up and going. You just need some paper and then your tool, your linking tool, and you'll get this. You only need one of them, so you should be fine with it. And then it runs you through here in the quest line on how to actually utilize it, but I'm going to show it to you really quick. So right now, we already have a color in it. There's purple, so we're going to throw it down. We actually don't need this dye on us. It's not useful. All you need are these three colors here, so red, blue, and green. So all we have to do is we'll right click to remove the color, utilizing our wand there, our linking tool. We're going to throw this back down, right? And then what we want again is purple. So I'm going to throw red and blue because that'll make purple. Now you are going to have to tinker with it to get the exact color that you want. But for us, this is going to be perfect. So now we have this. Now, if we did want to change it again, you don't even have to set it back to default. What we could do is say we want that, and then two red on it. We could do that, and it's going to give us a little bit more of a pinkish color. So again, you'll kind of just have to tinker around to see what exactly you want it to be. But again, for us, we're going to go with this nice deep purple. I think it's going to look pretty sick. Then all we got to do is come over here, and I think it said right click, or is it shift right click? We'll have to look at it again. You can then right click the pedestals with it to paint them. All right. I mean, that is what I am doing. We are right clicking the pedestals with this guy. It doesn't want to change it. Is something off? Yeah, this shows you how you, here you go. You can actually see the different colors that you you can put there. And then use on pedestal. That's very interesting. So if I have no idea. Oh, you can place it sideways too. Okay, I think this is, I don't know, I can't get it to work for some reason. All right, so I figured it out. I'm sure many of you were probably already clickety-clacking down in the comments section, but you actually have to hold it in your offhand in order to get it to change colors. So I did that. I put it in our offhand here, and then it applied it by right-clicking on it. Now, unfortunately, it is like a one-to-one use, so you make one, and you can only use it one time, and that's it, which is a bit of a bummer. So we do have our singular colored, purple-colored pedestal here. I mean, hey, it is what it is. So the other thing that I do want to do then is get our cobblestone upgrade up and going. So you put it on your offhand once again, and you right-click, and as you can see, it's going to start making those. And it did show the inventory very briefly. I don't know how we had that. Yeah, I don't know how, but it showed us the inventory. Oh, there we go. Wait, hang on. Maybe. Oh, it showed it to us. There we go. Very briefly. So it's accumulating all of those. Now, what we'll want to do is export these guys, right? I think we'll want to export them because we'll want a decent amount of cobblestone, right? Like, we want to save it up. Like, we don't want to just get rid of it. So, like, let's do that. But would it make sense to actually test out, like, an item, like a storage upgrade? Like, that would be kind of cool. If we could upgrade storage on it and just keep them all stored within there, and then, but I don't know how we would access it. Okay, this is where another mod could come into play here. So if we jump over into here and we go to storage on our side, we also have the option for iron chests, which would be really cool to get into. So pretty much all we need to get is an iron chest and a wood to iron chest upgrade. So we need both of those. So iron chest, let's get that going. And then they also have the wood to chest upgrade. I think we could do this instead, actually. And then upgrade a normal chest and then go from there. So let's do this really quick. We should have everything that we need for it. And we're also going to need a normal chest. Is it thunderstorming outside? I don't know, it's hard to tell. Let's sleep through the night here. And then we're going to keep on going on. All right. Cool, we'll get that. And then we'll nix off all of these. And then we just need a normal chest, honestly. Like, that's all we really need is a chest. Unfortunately, it's in default to what we potentially have in our inventory. Let's see here. Can we look up chest, please? We do have a chest. Cool. Let's request that. Because we should be able to get this going. Oh, we only had to do one or the other. Okay. It made it seem like you needed both of them. But you don't have to have both of them, which is pretty nice. Okay. What did we get from that? We just got some bricks. Okay. We'll throw those in here. But I'll show you guys, you can make it two different ways. You can either make it outright, or if you already have a chest and you want to upgrade it, let's say this one right here, you take the upgrade, you right-click on it, and now you have an iron chest, which is astronomically larger in capacity than your base chest and taking up the same amount of space. Now you can go up to the gold tier, which honestly is not that bad. And we could honestly get this going. So iron to gold chest upgrade, we could request those. You can then even go up to diamond. You can go, I think you can swap over, right? Silver to gold, copper to iron, diamond to crystal, wood to copper, and then diamond to obsidian. Like, there's a whole bunch of different options and upgrades. Or if, again, if you outright wanted to make it, you could potentially do that. Get a little bit of a drink of coffee here because my voice is going. But as you can see, it's even larger, which is awesome. Now, we could do the diamond one, but I don't want to utilize all of our diamonds because we really don't have many of them. And I know it's going to be quite a bit to get that up and going. So let's utilize this. I think this would be kind of cool. And I don't know if we could use pipes to export it. That'd be kind of interesting to see. But as you can see, it's accumulating the cobble just in there. So maybe we don't actually have to get it out of there. We could probably just leave it in there. I don't know. Because I do want to utilize that to crush up stuff. Okay, let's get some of those. Let's head back over to our pedestals. And I do want to check out how to get up and going the crusher. So let me take a peek into that. All right, guys. So I got up and going a couple things here. As you can see in my offhand, we have some more upgrades. I'll show you in just a second what these are. So these are two grindstone upgrades, right? Crushing upgrades, my bad. Crushing upgrades, which is awesome. And these are the normal ones. So if we go into the quest line here, progressing it down towards the crusher, we have the pedestal machinery. So pedestal has a series of upgrades to allow you to process materials within them. The regular version runs on burnables dropped near them. When the pedestal has fuel on board, it will emit fire particles around its base. Otherwise, you can create one that runs on power or FE. So if we go into the crusher upgrades, as you can see, we have the base one and then we have the upgraded one. And all we need to do with that is get redstone on it. So we don't have any redstone currently, or we have redstone currently, but that's not what I want to be using here. So what we need to do from here is now transfer things to and from. So we're going to have to get this going a little bit more. So we have the import and export one, which I think we have to use both of them for. So we would want to export on these ones, right? We would need to export this one to the one below it. So I think we can put this on it. Maybe not. Maybe because it already has one on it. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Hang on. There we go. Yep, put that back on there. Don't know where all that cobblestone went then. Is it just gone? We might have lost some cobblestone, which is a bit of a bummer. Okay, I think I need to tinker around with this because we obviously want to like pipe stuff over to this one then and pull it in. And I think that we might be able to do it, or we have to link. Can we link? So that... whoa, what is this? Area? What the hell is this? Okay. Cannot be linked to itself. Link successful. Okay, so I linked it over there. Okay, let me tinker with this. All right, guys, I think we're actually good to go here. I think I got everything set up for the most part. I'm going to show you really quickly how we can do something. And again, guys, I do want to preference, like, this is my first time going through the pedestals mod. So you'll have to bear with me. I'm sure that there are way quicker and more efficient ways to do things. But for me being a beginner, this is what we got into right off the bat. Anywho, so basically this is going to be a whole entire automated system from taking cobblestone production all the way down to sand. Now, do we necessarily need to have it continuously running? No, we don't have to have it continuously running. But, I mean, we're backlogging such a good amount of cobblestone here that I'm not too worried about it. We could always kind of divert it so we have this link to do different inventories that would ultimately hold it. But I think we'll have enough, and I think we'll be good to go. And also, too, these pedestals take power, and you have to drop some coal on them to get them moving. So I'm going to place that back down there, and I'm going to show you guys how the ultimate setup worked here. Let me just get some of this knocked out here so we can kind of take a little bit of a step back and ultimately see everything. So we have our first pedestal here, which is creating our cobblestone generator. From here, it is going to be linked to another pedestal that has an export functionality on it. Now, for whatever reason, I couldn't get it to work in the exact way I wanted to, but between linking from like a cobblestone generator to a crusher here, and maybe we would be able to do that here. I'm not 100% sure. I don't know. I'm guessing not, because the crushers take from an inventory below it in order to actually do their crushing features or functionality. But anyway, I couldn't get this working at first, but then realized the way that we needed to do it. So in order to get this working, we have the cobblestone generator, and this needs to be sent to the inventory down here. However, you can't just link between the two. So I have another pedestal down here that has an exporter on it. So that has the export upgrade there. So pretty much what we're going to do is you have to start with this one. For whatever reason, if I started here and link to here, it doesn't work. We kind of have to work backwards on this. So we will click on it, right click on it, and then right click on this one. And it has now been set. You should get some particle effects here, I believe. And it should start working. My bad, I actually misspoke there. So it's actually shift right click. You want to shift right click, and we've already selected that one, and then shift right click up there. And as you can see, we're getting some particle effects, and cobblestone is being pushed down here. And you can see it is accumulating, and then it will ultimately export into here, which is awesome. Now, the next thing that we have going on is we have this pedestal up here with the crushing upgrade, the same with this one as well. And then basically all we got to do here is throw a little bit of coal over there. And we probably will want a way for this to work automatically. But with that being done, it should pull in the cobblestone from underneath it. And then it'll turn it into gravel. Let's see if it'll do it again. It's kind of slow, to be completely honest. It will probably put a speed upgrade, but you saw it turn it into gravel. From there, again, I have this pedestal linked down to this one down here. So again, you want to do it reverse. You want to shift, right click, and it'll link the two. It's sending them down here and putting it into another chest, the gravel. And then the gravel is getting done up in here into sand. And then the sand is being linked to this pedestal down here, which then is giving us an output of sand. So pretty much this is a whole entire automated process in which we're not only creating unlimited cobblestone, but we're also generating a good source of sand, which is something that we, again, were greatly lacking on. Now we can cover this up, and I think you want to leave a space for the items above. Like, I don't think, like, I guess we could put it there, but it looks, I don't know, I'll leave it open. It's perfectly fine, as is, like that. We'll get all of this filled in. That does not go there. But the other cool thing that this can be used for is ore production as well. You can duplicate your ores, which is really nice. And we will get a setup for that going as well. But this is pretty nice on its own. Like, this works really well. Now, again, we'll probably want a way that we can get some coal just dropping every so often. Or get to a point where we could implement some power to it. But we also then have to implement wireless power, and that kind of defeats the purpose. So I don't think we need to have this running all the time, to be completely honest with you guys. I think stopping in every so often to get it rolling is perfect, and we can still access this. Now, I did put a golden chest down here so we could accumulate quite a bit of cobblestone. And the other thing that we can do, actually, I believe, is put upgrade on here. So we do have the pedestal speed upgrade. So I think I can just click it. Nope. I need to get that back. Where did it go? I think it transferred already. Yeah, transferred. I think we have to put it in our offhand, if I'm not mistaken. And then click it. Click on it, maybe? Shift click. We'll have to look into how we utilize these. We'll only accept the pedestal capacity when being enchanted. Can only add enchantments from book to upgrades with the anvil upgrade. Okay, hang on. Let's take a quick peek into our section here. So this is where it talks on it. So pedestal upgrades can be enchanted, but okay, blah, blah, blah. It talks on that. Let's jump to the next one here. It's wonderful that you can enchant your upgrades. These books allow you to ensure you get particular enchantments. You keep in mind that you cannot combine these with an upgrade in a vanilla anvil. You must use the XP anvil from pedestals. Ah, I see. So you can actually combine these, it looks like, with upgrades, advanced enchantments. Wow, okay, this gets very tricky. So if I were to take... Oh, I don't think I can get it off of there. Anyway, we'll tinker with it later. We're dragging on here. But yeah, so that's pretty awesome. We have our sick automated system going here, which is going to produce us a good amount of sand. Now, look at that. We almost have a half stack right there. But the other thing that we might want to do, I think it'll be fine. We'll definitely want to make sure that there's plenty of coal chilling out so that these keep running. But we might want to chunk load these. We'll deal with it later, though. But guys, with that being said, we do need to wrap up the episode there. We are sitting at 35 minutes almost here. So thank you so much for tuning in today. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, feel free to leave a like down below. If you are new here and you do want to follow along, definitely hit that subscribe button and bell notification. Lets you know every single time a new episode is posted here on the channel. We do stream over on Twitch. Link for that in the description down below, along with the link to our community Discord. If you feel like joining the community, or at the very least, staying up to date with things that are going on with the channel and with the stream, I try to post all those updates over there so you guys can stay informed and up to date. But guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me today as we went through and made our automated cobblestone generator and sand producer. I hope you enjoyed, and we'll catch you in the next one. Take it easy.